Hey everyone, welcome to my kitchen. This is where I make coffee in the mornings and sometimes oatmeal. You can see right over there. So I've got plenty of coffee here. Got a grinder and various brewing devices up in a cabinet here and all around. So anyway, welcome to my kitchen. So here today we're going to do a brewtorial, a little brewing demonstration about Turkish coffee. And Turkish coffee is a very particular method of brewing coffee. And so we're gonna use this guy. Typically it's a hand-hammered copper device called an ebrik, or there's another word for it, a çevze, or something like that. I'm gonna call it an ebrik, because that's easier. So anyway, we're gonna brew some Turkish coffee, so stay tuned and we'll get on with it. Okay. So one of the most important things about brewing Turkish coffee is that you have a vessel to brew the coffee in, kind of like this ebrik. I like to use a Bunsen burner, or I have this portable butane stove that we're going to use today to heat up our coffee and our water. I'm basically going to make enough for 2 cups of coffee, so I've got these 2 little cups. They're kind of espresso style or macchiato sized cups. Traditionally you would have a straight walled cup to do Turkish coffee, but I don't have any of those handy. So this is the water we're going to need. So I've got that ready. I also got some of our Sumatra and coffee, the Sumatra Atu Lintang from Numa Coffee, and I stopped at my local shop and got that ground. And this is the other thing that's particular about Turkish coffee, is the grind needs to be very powdery, pretty much as fine as you can get the grind. That's what we're going for with Turkish coffee. Okay, so we're not going to filter the coffee, you're just going to let the grinds settle to the bottom after we brew. But basically for each cup, we're not going to use scales or measure everything precisely, but we're going to do it in a more traditional manner today. We're just going to take 1 heaping teaspoon per each cup that you want to brew. So I've got 2 big scoops of coffee. That just a little stir. And then also traditionally, Turkish coffee is brewed with sugar. So I've got just 2 packs of raw sugar, about 2 teaspoons of raw sugar. And so we're gonna give this not much of a stir. I just wanna submerge everything. We're going to wait and allow the brewing process itself, the heating of the water, to sort of caramelize the sugar and mix things up in there. So again, if you have a gas stove, you could use this ebrik over a flame like this, or you could do it over an electric burner as well. It's just a little quicker and more effective with the gas heat source. I'm going to dial that heat down a little bit. I don't want to cook this too quickly. So this water's at room temperature. We've added the coffee. We've added the sugar. Now we'll add just a little bit of heat. And it's starting to boil. I can see some little bubbles forming around the edges. What we want to do is begin to boil the water. It's going to create a nice crema, a nice foamy layer at the top. But just before it boils over, we want to remove it from the heat. You can see that all the foam is kind of moving to the center, and the water is boiling up around the edges. We'll sugars in there are caramelizing. And obviously the coffee itself is steeping and extracting in the water. Turn up the heat just a little bit. Okay, we're just about to boil over here. All right, I'm gonna remove that from the heat. And at this point, you wanna scoop out a little bit of that crema, that foam. Just put into each of your cups. Now we're gonna bring that to a boil one more time. You want to be careful not to let it boil over and make a big mess there. All right. Now we're done. We're just going to pour this slowly into our two cups. And hopefully as you pour, the crema, the foam that we put in there earlier, is going to just sort of rise to the surface on top of this liquid. I don't know if you can see, you'll notice in the bottom of the ebrick, there's still a lot of coffee grounds in there. And that's just what happens with Turkish coffee. And so that's Turkish coffee. Now, ideally, you want to let that settle just a little bit before you drink it, let it cool, and let some of the grounds settle to the bottom. And when you're drinking Turkish coffee, and especially when you get near the end of the cup, you want to be careful not to drink the very last kind of drop, so to speak, because you're going to have a lot of coffee sediment in the bottom of the cup. Traditionally, it's served with a cup of water so that you can kind of cleanse, refresh your palate before you try it. But there we go, Turkish coffee. It's very good. It's very good. A little bit sweet, very intense, rich flavor. I've always thought that this brew method would just produce kind of over-extracted, bitter flavors. But I think there's something about the way that it brews with the caramelizing sugar that balances out those bitters. So there you go. If you want to play around with Turkish coffee, I encourage you to just order one of these ebricks. They're pretty easy to find online and order, and not very expensive. Get some coffee, some fresh local roasted coffee. Grind it on the Turkish setting of the grinder at your coffee shop, or just grind it on your own grinder as absolutely fine and powdery as you can. It should be almost like flour when you're done grinding. Just add the sugar, add the water, bring it to boil once, don't let it boil over, pour that foam off into your cup, and then bring it to boil again without letting it boil over. And then maybe let it sit just a minute before you then pour it into your cups and enjoy. So, hey, thanks for joining us for this little brewtorial. And you can order some coffee if you need it, numacoffee.com. And we would greatly appreciate it. Take care.